I think scientists at Berkeley actually have been able to, this data comes out of a book that was based on data from Berkeley, suggesting that a child born in 2007 has a 50% chance of living to 104.
After reading that quote, I was thinking, well, maybe some of these lifestyle interventions that we know to regulate the aging process that we know that can have a positive effect on health span. Can you maybe tell people a little bit about what are some of the main lifestyle interventions that are known to regulate the aging process, at least in animal models?
Yes, and in humans as well. I think there are, you know, four broad categories of things that are being considered by the aging field. One is exercise, is to this day the surest, best intervention that we have to increase health span and lifespan. The second one is nutrition. And there's a lot of research going on today trying to understand what is it about nutrition? Is it carbohydrates versus fat versus proteins? What is the relative role of all these nutrients in your lifespan and health span? The third one, which is actually an active field of investigation, is the identification of molecules that mimic either exercise or the sort of exercise mimetic or mimic restriction in terms of nutrients, so what we call calorie restriction mimetics. And finally, the last part of the whole aging field is the idea of rejuvenation. So the first three approaches are geared towards slowing down the process of aging. Rejuvenation takes the approach that once the aging has occurred, how can you repair it and how can you fix it? So I think, you know, we have programs here that are studying all four different approaches. I think you're probably familiar with Jack LaLanne, who is one of the gurus that started the American infatuation with exercise. And he said he lived to 100 years old, and he said that exercise is king, nutrition is queen. Put them together, and you have a kingdom, which I think is really true. So I think it's, you know, for me and many of my colleagues, I think exercise and nutrition is the cornerstone of what we're trying to do today, mm-hmm. until we have better drugs.